what's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. It is your natural nail guru, Tati, and today we have a very juicy subject to go over. We're going to be talking about electric files and cuticle care. Look at all that cuticle cleanup with electric files. Many would say it is oddly satisfying, and I would say it is entirely disturbing. I do not like to see cuticles cleaned with electric files. Now, I'm not going to talk about why this is wrong or why I think it is wrong. I'm going to talk about why I don't use this method in my shop, why it's not allowed. And I guess you could say it is wrong in comparison to the manicure process that I've established for my shop. Now, for context, anyone who's new to the channel, or maybe this is just the first video of mine that you see, I am the Natural Nail Guru. My shop is all focused on services that help ensure the overall health and strength and improvement of your natural nails. That includes the cuticle care, growth, I mean, all across the board. Everything that I do in the shop is to help promote that, to encourage healthier nails, to rehabilitate nails, and to keep them on point, as well as getting you the longest lasting manicure. So everything that I do and don't do in my shop is because that is my end goal. So if a process doesn't work towards improving it or has too much risk of working against it, I don't do it. Now, the cuticle step in the manicure process is, for me, the most important step in the manicure process. You can literally mess anything else up in the manicure, and as long as you have the care of that cuticle on point, you will see improvement in overall nail health, the growth, and your skin health. Not just the cuticle, but the eponychium, which is the skin that surrounds the cuticle. So let's just do a quick little reminder. Cuticle is very, very thin, almost translucent skin that grows on top of the nail with the nail. So as the nail is growing out, the cuticle skin is growing out with it. If we are not pushing that cuticle back, it is, number one, dragging your nail down. So it's gonna slow the overall nail growth because you have this skin that's growing as the nail is growing out, and that skin is kind of holding it back. So you definitely wanna make sure that you're pushing back the cuticle to free it. Another reason why it's really important to push back the cuticle, because again, this is skin that's growing from the base of your nail out. So if you're not pushing it back little by little, that skin is going to become thick, it's going to become very visible if it isn't already, and it's definitely going to cause a lot of severe overgrowing. You're literally not even going to be able to tell the difference between your cuticle and your eponychium, okay? The eponychium is the skin around the nail plate, which a lot of people cut and do things they're not supposed to do with it. That's not cuticle, that is eponychium, that protects your nail bed, okay? Now, when you are using an electric file to clean up that cuticle, all you're doing is going in and filing and shaving off that dead skin all around the base of your nail, all around the eponychium. And oh my God, it looks right so satisfying when they're just going in there and they're shaving all that away. But guys, this is not okay. This is not okay. Number one, cuticle and the skin around your nail, the eponychium, is all live skin, okay? And it's very sensitive live skin. So think calluses, right? When you go to the gym or you're doing something, brooming a lot, and you're putting, writing maybe, you're putting a lot of pressure on a particular part of your body, you develop a callus. The callus gets developed because the skin's being irritated, so it's a defense mechanism. It's protecting itself because it doesn't want to blister and bleed and get really sore, okay? So all of that cuticle, all of that eponychium, all that healthy live tissue that you have all around the nail plate now is getting completely irritated by this vibration of the electrical file. Now, there are electrical file bits that are specifically made for cuticle, but it's still irritating the skin. It's not helping. It is looking really good, right? Because it's shaving all that stuff off and it looks really, really awesome. But you're probably more likely gonna see over the next couple of days after getting your manicure that the skin starts getting very dry. Maybe even you get little skins that start sticking up. Maybe after the first week, second week, you have super, super thick cuticle all over again. It is really, really thick, really bulky, not looking really cute. Now, if you're getting a regular manicure every 2, 3, 4 weeks, your cuticle should not be looking in shambles at the end of that manicure when you're ready to come in, okay? It really should not. Your cuticle should remain healthy. You should actually see improvement in the growing of the cuticle, right? You'll have less, it won't be stuck to the nail as much, It won't be as thick. Now, some people hereditarily have naturally really, really thick cuticle, really, really thick skin. I know for me, my cuticle grows out a lot. And it's very, very visible. So, you know, hereditary traits do play a part in that. But even then, if you're getting a proper manicure, you will see an improvement in how your cuticle reacts. It's not going to grow as much. It's not going to be as stuck. It's definitely going to improve. But it's only going to do that if you're treating the cuticle right. And all that is just pushing and removing the cuticle, not irritating it, not cutting skin that's not meant to be cut. And not using an electric file to irritate all of that healthy skin tissue that's there. And as you can see, here are a couple of pictures of my clients. These are clients that are nurses, teachers. They deal with money and paper all day long. They're typing all day long. And many of my clients wear their manicures for 3, 4, some of them even 5 weeks. And no matter how overgrown their nails are, their cuticle is healthier than ever before. And that's across the board. That's all my clients. I have not one client that hasn't improved the health of their natural nails in every aspect, not just one either. So again, I repeat, I'm not going to say it's wrong necessarily, but I just want to make you aware of why I don't use it. And remember, our goals here are to improve the health of your natural nails. So if there's any step of the process that might work against it, I throw it out. So electric files, I have lots more that needs to be said, but today I really wanted to just focus on the cuticle care part because I've been seeing so many videos of people getting their cuticles shaved off with these things, and it honestly drives me crazy. But I hope that I was able to at least give you an understanding as to why it is that this step is a no-no in my shop. And if you're struggling with your cuticle health, and this is getting done to you when you're getting your manicures, it might be the reason. It likely is the reason why your cuticle is unhealthy because of that electric file. So please, if anyone has any questions whatsoever on this, please comment down below. Make sure that you're watching my videos on perfect manicure, why your nails don't grow, improving nail health after having acrylics. All of those really talk about pushing the cuticle back because that is the most essential aspect of your entire manicure. And it really just leads to so many other healthy improvements in the nail. Okay, does that make any sense? I hope so. But thank you again, everyone, for tuning in. If you want to be up to date with the most thorough nail product reviews, all the tips that are going to help improve the health of your natural nails, get them to grow, and obviously get you the longest lasting manicures, and you know what to do, please make sure that you subscribe, get those notifications on. This is truly just the beginning. I have so much more to share. And for all of those that have already subscribed and are watching the videos and commenting, I love you guys. Thank you so much. I appreciate you so much. You have absolutely no idea. So yeah, that's all we have for today. Thank you everyone for tuning in. I hope it was informative, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.